In this video, we're just going to do a couple examples of finding volume of prisms. So this example asks to first give the dimensions of the base and then find the volume of the square prism. So first we want to recognize that this is, in fact, a square prism because we can see that the two bases are squares. And so the dimensions of the square would be 5 and 5. And then the 12 would be the height of the prism. So to find the volume of this prism, remember the formula is area of the base times the height. In this case, because it's a square, the area of the base is base times height, or if you want to think of it as side squared, times the height of the prism. So 5 times 5, area of the base, times 12, which is the height of the prism, we would get 25 times 12, which is 300 cubic units. Here we have a right triangular prism. So again, we want to recognize that the base of this prism happens to be a right triangle. And we also want to recognize that in a triangle, in order to find the area of the base, which is a right triangle, we need to know the base and the height of that triangle. Well, we know that 4 represents either the base or the height, but we need to figure out this leg of the triangle because that would be the other piece, either the base or the height. So volume is equal to area of the base times the height of the prism. In this case, the base is a triangle, so we have to do 1/2 times base times height. Times the height of the prism. I can see that 7 is the height of the prism. I'm going to call 4 the base of the triangle, so I need to find x. Well, what you want to recognize is that this is a 30, 60, 90 triangle given to us right here is a 30 degree angle, and since 4 is opposite the 30 degree angle, that means that 4 represents the short leg. So if I multiply 4 times 2, I get the hypotenuse. And if I multiply 4 times root 3, I get the other piece that I'm missing, which is 4 root 3. Notice that the directions asked for exact, so I want to leave it as 4 root 3. And so now I have what I need to do the volume formula. 1/2 times 4, which is the base of the right triangle, times 4 root 3, which is the height of the right triangle, times 7, which is the height of the prism. Now when I multiply this together, I'm going to do 1/2 times 4 times 4 times 7, and then just attach the root 3. And so we get an answer of 56 root 3. And that is again going to be cubic units because we are doing volume.